Good day, everybody, and welcome to another edition of the Military and Foreign Affairs Network. I am your host, the Voice of Reason. In the ongoing coverage of the civil war taking place inside of the former state of Ethiopia, the fighting continues. The alleged offensive by the Ethiopian federal military, the remnants of the federal military supported by thousands and thousands and thousands of semi-conscripted Amhara militia units continue to press a very frayed attack at this point. It would appear that the operation that is being conducted by the Ethiopian federal state appears to be unraveling before it really even gets off the ground, so to speak. The casualties that are trickling in through human intelligence that are supporting the free flow of information, and at times risking themselves to do this, indicate that there are fairly significant casualties on the part of the Ethiopian / Amhara military forces that are attempting to move northward towards the Tigray border, down from Dese and then west of Gishina. So we'll start first in the vicinity of Dese and report that there has been really no gains made in this operation. Especially in the vicinity of Dese, a lot of units, a lot of Ethiopian units that are deployed have significant morale issues. Obviously, many of them have been recruited, possibly forced conscription at some point via peer pressure into military service, and are not wanting to be where they're at right now. And unfortunately, that is showing on the battlefield. Again, there are large numbers of Ethiopian Amhara forces based in the vicinity of Dese, attempting to move both west and east of Dese north. However, it is just simply not going well for them. There's not a lot of movement. There is not a lot of traction. Objectives have not been completed. Phase lines have not been crossed. And it is a very, very difficult situation right now for the Ethiopian state. Compounding that is a little side issue, but there also appears to be conflicting command structure, conflicting leadership structure. So, an instance on social media and media outlets that represent themselves to be part of the Ethiopian regime, we are hearing conflicting information coming out of that side as well. On one hand, there is no offensive. On the other hand, there is an offensive. On the other hand, it's a small offensive. And then on the other hand, it is a very, very large offensive. So it would really appear that one side within this leadership circle wants to press this very hastily prepared offensive, and then the other side is keen on really not moving forward at a certain point. And we can see that infighting is fairly serious at this point. In other parts of the region, we continue to hear fighting west of Gishina. It would appear that from reports that are coming in that, in fact, the Amhara militias and the Ethiopian military have made forward progress in the vicinity of Arbit. Again, Arbit is a very small town, very, very small. If you drive through it and you blink, you probably will miss it. But it would appear that these forces, these Ethiopian Amhara forces, have pressed from Falakit and are in the vicinity of Arbit as we speak. Gishina is still well under the control of the Tigrayan Defense Forces, but heavy fighting continues in this area. In a front that has not been as active, and this was not a part of the original planned two-pronged offensive by the Ethiopian military is up here just north of Dabark. And it would appear that we could be seeing a limited offensive operation by the Tigrayan Defense Forces. It would appear that Zarema is under the process of being shelled. We also hear that forces of the TDF are getting closer to Zarema, and we could possibly see that city come under the control again of the Tigrayan Defense Forces. So again, it is quite a bit like a whack-a-mole for the Ethiopian military. You attack the TDF in one place, and they pop up in another region to haunt you again, so to speak. And that is definitely what is occurring along many fronts of this conflict. And that has always been the war strategy, especially when the conflict was inside of the Tigray region. But as we know, those forces were driven out of the Tigray region, and now the fighting is deep inside of the Amhara region. So I want to also talk about the nature of this conflict as well, and I think this is important. Please understand, this is not a modern war by any stretch of the imagination in terms of Western militaries, in terms of what we saw in the conflict that took place between the Azeris and the Armenians. Even that was not entirely modern in many cases, especially if you're on the side of the Armenians fighting the combined forces of the Turks and the Azeris. And that was probably the most recent, which you could define as a modern conflict. But this conflict that we're seeing now is really variations of conflicts through history. Unfortunately, a lot of the forces being deployed by both sides, the Ethiopian military and the Tigrayan Defense Forces, none of them are wearing body armor. In most cases, they don't even wear helmets. I've seen very, very few photographs or videos of any forces wearing protective headgear, and that is simply not occurring. A lot of these forces are not mechanized. They are traveling overland via foot, and again, use of tanks and armored infantry vehicles is sporadic, but by and large, this is an infantry war, a war between two very large formations of infantry, like we would see during World War I or even in periods during World War II, with elements of heavy armor being thrown in, and then some of these more advanced technologies such as drone use also intermingling the equation. But by and large, this is a very large infantry combat like we've seen in World War I. It is a very strange war, I would say, in terms of the modern technology that exists and some of the tactics that we are seeing in the region. It's definitely something that can lead to some really horrendous casualties on both sides. And in fact, I believe we will probably see that as this conflict goes on, and we've seen it prior as well inside of this conflict. But that is the situation on the ground right now. Very free-flowing situation. I'm not going to declare that the Ethiopian operation has completely stalled and there's no chance for it to pick things back up again. But right now, from where I sit, and as we continue to analyze this, it would appear that the operation is not going well for the Ethiopian military. There really appears to be a unity of command issue and a morale issue. Granted, it does appear they are using variations of drones. It could be three different types of drones for all we know, between Turk, Iranian, and Chinese drones. But again, we don't believe they are being fielded right now in the amounts that could be used where you could just use air power alone to win this conflict. And that is just not the case at this point. But again, we will continue to monitor the situation and report on the facts on the ground. Have a great day, everybody. We'll have another video soon.